Okay, what are we missing? I'm missing my camera. Bear with me here. I'm just going to try and see if I can get my camera working. I'll put something up to look at. Grog, proprietor of the Happy Half Ogre Inn, has engaged the characters to clear his name. And, okay, there. Camera's working. So where is it? I'm just going to play with the layout for a second. Bear with me, please. OBS. Okay. So it should be on top. Oh well, I'm gonna stop fiddling with that. You don't need to see me. Okay. For today, go with without. Okay. So, our intrepid adventurers have sortied twice into the underground of Dagger Rock. Okay, let's. That's this map. Okay. And let's. We want to see everything, so let's just pull it up. Yeah, they're still here. So they had a battle with the villains of the story. So now I've got to decide. They have to go back because what has happened is that from the other side, from the Dagger Rock Tavern, the ranger, Captain Bearclaw, and the townspeople could not break through into their kind of secret lair underground. So party exited after battling them, and now they have to go back in. So I've had, as a complicating factor, them battling a couple waves of undead in the underground here. So what I'm thinking is how much I want to extend that and develop that plot. So they've been going in with the cleric and NPC in support. And I'm trying to figure out where to go with that. Been reading the Empire of the Ghouls, and it has some neat ideas for what to do with undead. Actually, just give me a second. I'm going to turn off this fan behind me. So, what to challenge them with? Like, I was thinking of breaking off and having new tunnels coming in where the ghouls have been digging and tunneling, although the graveyard is down here, so. So it might fit better there. Let's look at undead. What fun undead could be, maybe. Actually, I should load up some of the other monster books too. Modules. I have the universal module extension running, so I can load from different rule sets. So there's a lot of modules to choose from. But I just want the 2E ones, or the Osric ones, actually. There's what was that? And chap, a map pack, or maybe take a look at that for a map to extend it. Oh yeah, and the monsters of myth. And then the malevolent and benign are the ones I'm looking for. Takes a bit for me to load these up. There we go. Load it up, and we can sort by type undead and see what. So we can sort the NPCs by the type of NPC. Undead. Let's see what we've got to choose from. Now Banshee's too much for this group. Oh, I've got to watch out because it's also some 5e stuff here because I've got Ghosts of Saltmarsh loaded up for materials here too. Barrel corpse. What's that? Four hit dice. Neutral evil. Oh, regeneration. Energy drain. I don't really want to put that on first level characters. Coffer corpse. Coffer corpse is fun, but and normal weapons don't damage them. These guys are just starting out characters, so very sparse on magic weapons. Death Knight. Way too badass. Just curious. Deceived, upset. What's that? Donkey skull mummy chained to a post. Oh, that's interesting. I think it doesn't quite fit the flavor. What's this look like? Wow. That's kind of funky looking. No, no Demi-Lich, no. Dracolich, no, no, no. Yes. Ghouls aren't quite powerful enough because they're all elves. My whole party is elves. Yeah, so. Is there paralyzation effects? Elves. I do believe. Just double check. Oh, check this one. There's a couple of versions. I've got the Osric version and the 2e versions. Yeah. So the Osric, I should let maybe Sterno know, but it will affect elves, because that's what I recall. So that might be a little surprise for them. Have some ghouls and throw a ghast in there. Well, I'd actually done that in my original encounter, but I had to scale it back midstream because they were I loaded the encounter because they had the cleric with them, but the cleric went down just right away. So then I took the ghast off because just, they would have been in trouble because then they encountered the villains of the town immediately after. So it was a tough battle for them, but it was good. It worked out best that I took that off because I think they would have been in trouble if I hadn't scaled it back. But let me look at that encounter again, because maybe I could bring that back. Yeah, so I had one ghast, skeletons and zombies, two ghouls. Going down there again. And it might be time to encounter the ghast. Because they're not going to be battling those other people again. I also want to make it a story. So the undead have been disturbed. Well, the zombies and skeletons, they're activated because of all the digging, including traffic through the cemetery, which is what they were using as their back entrance. So, need to tie that into story somehow. Okay. I might want a map. Where are those maps I just pulled? Ice Forge, Crypts and Chapels. That's an interesting looking crypt. Though I can't explain why there'd be all these lights in it because it's abandoned. That's interesting to use sometime. Nice detail on the map. Cool. What they made this with. Okay. Yeah, I think. Because I'm going to use one of these to do the reflect the actual encounter they had, and so do the appropriate experience. So, gas comes off. Taking any skeletons out? I think I might have taken a zombie. I think that's reasonable. Then I can give them the XP for that. Recalculate. XP. Rename this. Ghouls and friends. I guess if they defeat the ghast, the priest can reconsecrate the ground, fill in the holes, and that can be enough. Just need to figure out where to go with this. I'm gonna have to, so I want to make some connections. So first encounter party had, they were the slavers tried to capture them. I can award this experience. Oh, I need it. Award that for them too. And then, so for that battle. Sorry, it's just in Discord for a sec. Okay, so that battle. Let's see. Give him 1,000. Award it. Okay. Looking good. Now, probably going to travel to Saltmarsh. I'm going to want to break that up with an encounter at some point. Let's see what the tables the 5e book has for encounter tables. You know what? Do I have DM? I have the 2e version. Sinister Secret 2. Do they have anything about the region? There we go. just see if there's any encounter tables around here. Where's my map, anyways? Get my bearings. Got the Saltmarsh region here somewhere. Search for it. Yeah, I had it in there. I just must have missed it. Okay. Okay. So, that's where they are. Now, shadow. Might be interesting. Magic weapon to hit, though. Oh yeah, I have to put in the party sheet what those guys were carrying. Okay, what else? Okay. Still don't know why that camera's not working. If I move this window, or how am I messing things up? Okay, just leave it alone. Okay. Okay, so he's got. Just make this so it's not so obvious it's a magic item. A new ornate dagger. Oh, that's. I must have the. Yeah, I do have the party item identified. That's a handy extension because then you can see what is not ID'd for the party. Okay, another magic item. Oh, he should have been throwing those. Oh, he really should have been throwing those and then attacking. That was foolish of me. That would have been. I forget what the status of Yuri was at the end. It's down. Can't remember. Look in the Discord. See if they discussed. give a nice description for the potion. Endure. So, I'm not going to give away a metal clasp, make it obvious, so. Excuse me. Okay, so I don't want to make it too obvious that the cloak is a magic item. So the metal clasp. DM notes. Okay, so that's handled by that. I don't have to put the metal class separately. I have to do a calculation, see how much it has. Dagger. Longsword. Bring a feather for me. That's going to take some time next session sorting through all that. Okay. Well, that's good. Have that organized. Oh, see, there's random encounter tables there. Never mind. Oh, yeah, I want to load. compare. Let's see what. Oh, it's curious. The NPCs. And I put the NPCs into character roster. There it goes. Okay, so he did it like this. So we just put an image of it. Oh, there. I should view it there. That's what I meant. So he didn't actually make these for the module as pre-gens. He just gave the image. Okay, so distributed XP, loaded up the treasure. Take a look at that encounter, the undead, for next time. Yeah, anything else is going to be too badass for these guys at first level. So throwing in the ghast. With some ghouls, some zombies and skeletons might be the way to go. Turning undead. Just want to see. Mechanics for 2E. Oh, you know what? I need to look up. She is a Priestess of Palor. And like to see if there any, what the powers are. Do pay more. So, someone did. A specialty priest. Specialty priest of Baylor. Dragon's foot. From the ashes. Okay, I'll have to look at that later. Okay, so that's that. Anything interesting here? Skeleton slime. What is that? Oh, that's interesting. Because of the gelatin. That's funny. Now that is interesting and different. I like that. And the freak about the slime coming off of it. Yes, that is very cool. Wow, I got a lot of hit dice. So I think there's only gonna be one of those. Find a token for it too. Oh, those tokens. I just grabbed a bunch of tokens, so let me pull those up. There they are. Okay, cool. So I can have a custom skeleton token for this guy. Okay. So I need to drop that guy in here. Drop a bunch of these in there. I made these for some reason. Now, if I go into campaign, how come I only have grog now still? Okay, I'll fix that later. But give them all that token. Something they'll mix in. Okay, I'm recharging. Interesting. Okay, so I'll throw it on the map. Yeah, them with the three attacks. It's no joke either. Without the paralyzation. The paralyzation. This can be kind of intense. Take out the zombies. Gotta balance this a bit. It's gonna be tough. Maybe we go three skeletons. Intelligent. Okay. Oh, hey, Canadian. Sorry, I was concentrating, so I didn't see your posts. Working up an encounter here on Fantasy Grounds for my next session next week. Found this thing called a gelatin, which is a skeleton that has been immersed in slime, and so it's actually resistant to blunt and edged weapons. And it's got four hit dice, it's kind of tough. So it's a bit of a different spin. So it'll be something the players will be wondering what the heck they've run into. Oh, you just slid through? Oh, you're lurking. Okay. Okay. Okay, so that is a good encounter. Place that. So they're going to be coming from that way, and then the ghoul tunnels can kind of loop back towards the graveyard, basically. Okay. Okay. Do now. So taking care of that treasure, good encounter for next time. By the time they take care of all the sorting through treasure, wrapping things up, yeah, that should be a decent session. Might want it like a wilderness encounter. Gotta think about that. Something else to, in case they do travel to Saltmarsh. I don't know if the region is the Saltmarsh regional. I need to put it on one of the hotkeys. Easy to refer to. This is from the 5e Ghosts of Saltmarsh, this map. Drowned Forest. Because the plan is to, I want to run them through U1, so the Sinister Secret. But then I don't want to go directly into U2. I want to, or well, even the ship, so I can do the haunted house, and then break, make an adventure, and then do the ship. They might even gain level in between. So to drop a dungeon, the Tower of Xenopus, or the Dwarven Mine, or I've kind of laid the groundwork back here for Shattered Circle. And they will come back after the haunted house to here. It's just a matter of how I want to structure it. Then there's also Night Below. I'm going to try and bring that along too. And I've also laid a hook for Cult of the Reptile God, so I have a lot of hooks hanging around. Just it's a sandbox, so I like to give the players agency to choose where they go. So after U1, I'll just throw a couple of the hooks out there and see which way they go. I don't want to muck around with the town of Saltmarsh, though. Town. Throw that in my folder here. Saltmarsh sandbox. It's a nice little map. Standing stones. Okay. So we should have enough for next session. I'll work on an extra encounter. I just got to get my Thursday game session figured out. Although it's pretty much said, it's just what direction they're going to go. It's a nice little sandbox there too. Well, thank you for viewing. I think I will raid now. Paraland's not coming up from the raid. Be good to well, here we go. Why can't I read? OBS. No. I fart around too much, so read.
Go right ahead.
All
not
right.
Unwise.
I don't know why it keeps rolling me on the friggin'.
The friggin'.
The friggin' D&D Beyond.